In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Jesus said to his disciples, "Hear the parable of the sower. The seed sown on the path is the one who hears the word of the kingdom without understanding it. And the evil one comes and steals away what was sown in his heart. The seed sown on rocky ground is the one who hears the word and receives it at once with joy. But he has no root and lasts only for a time. When some tribulation or persecution comes because of the word, he immediately falls away. The seed sown among thorns is the one who hears the word, but then worldly anxiety and the lure of riches choke the word, and it bears no fruit. But the seed sown on rich soil is the one who hears the word and understands it, who indeed bears fruit and yields 100 or 60 or 30-fold." The Gospel of the Lord. Today's gospel always reminds me a little bit of like a word problem in high school math, right? When they give you a mathematical problem kind of ensconced in a situation or embedded in some sort of story. And the mathematics at work here are twofold, right? First, we have a kind of a little bit of a negative mathematical situation. Why is it negative? Well, because out of the four possible landing points of the seed that's sown, only one is good soil, right? There are four, and three of them are bad. The seed sowed on rocky ground is the one who hears the word and receives it with joy, but has no root and lasts only for a time. The seed sown on the path is snatched up by the devil. The seed sown among thorns hears the word, but then worldly anxiety and the lure of riches choke the word and it bears no fruit. And then there's only one spot out of all four, which is rich soil, the one who hears the word and understands it. And so it looks like in order to have apostolic fruit, in order for people to hear the word of God and respond to it, you have to sow abundantly. You have to sow a lot, right? Because you're going to lose 75%. St. Paul says this. He says, thin sowing means thin reaping, right? So if you want a return on your investment in your Christian life, a return on your investment in your evangelization, you have to talk to a lot of people, and you have to talk to them frequently about God, about the things of God, about the faith, about the gospel. But the last line, right, makes up for this kind of, if you will, negative forecast of apostolate, of evangelization. The seed sown on rich soil is the one who bears the word and understands it, who indeed bears fruit and yields 100 or 60 or 30-fold, right? And so 30, 60, and 100 are all above 25%. And so even if only one out of four seeds falls on good soil, it's going to make up for your losses, right? Because some of it's going to yield 100-fold, some of it's going to yield 60-fold, some of it's going to yield 30-fold. And so in the end, the word of God is fruitful, and the numbers come out, right? The numbers come out higher than one would expect. And so let's always try to sow the word of God with our words, and perhaps first of all, with our actions. Pope Francis likes to quote Saint Francis on this. And Saint Francis used to say, "Preach the gospel always, and if necessary, speak." Right? Preach the gospel always in everything you do, and if necessary, also talk about it. And I think at times, and St. Francis thought so too, I think at times it is necessary to speak about our faith. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.